This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video will cover how to move REDCap projects into production status and how to create and disseminate surveys. All REDCap projects start in development status. Users build and test projects in development status. After a project is developed and you have made sure the branching logic is working correctly, it's strongly recommended that you move the project from development status to production status before collecting real data. The term real data refers to true data entered by or collected from survey respondents. Real data entered in the project in development status can be compromised or lost if the REDCap user is not careful. There are a few key differences between development and production statuses. REDCap assigns codes to the various choices that survey respondents will select from. For example, 1, fever means that fever is coded as 1. This allows multiple choice options to have assigned codes when looking at the data. The key differences between development status and production status relate to how REDCap processes changes made to the survey and data after real data has been collected. In development status, changes are made in real time. Users can change what codes line up with specific choices, recode choices into alphabetical order, and apply these changes immediately to a project. Real data can be compromised while the project is in development status. For example, users can accidentally delete records and coding can be mismatched to data. While the freedom of development status is convenient for quick changes, it's important to note that changes made in development status cannot be reverted. In production status, REDCap requires changes to be submitted through the system, which is designed to keep track of all changes made. When changes are submitted, a summary of changes page will display a preview of the fields to be added, removed, and modified in the revision. The preview acts as a safeguard so users can review the changes before altering any data or removing it from the project. Production status also includes other safeguards, such as how each approved revision is tracked, archived, and can be compared to other revisions. Submitting changes through the system while in production status allows for built-in checks to safeguard against data loss, as altering fields mid-data collection may change the data validity. There are several ways that users can compromise data when editing a project in production status: deleting a field, changing a field type, changing the multiple choice options, or rewording a field label may result in data loss. For example, recoding field choices does not change the data saved to the database, but only updates the labels. This will change the meaning of the data previously entered, and records that have responses will need to be updated to ensure accuracy. Sometimes, a project user may need to change a field choice once a project is in production. For example, suppose a user discovers an important symptom has been left out of the initial questionnaire. In that case, they should add the symptom even though data collection has begun. Occasionally, project users will decide data previously collected is irrelevant. For example, suppose a symptom was initially included in the interview that is not a typical symptom consistent with foodborne outbreaks. In that case, the decision may be made to delete or change it to another symptom that may have been overlooked when the project was created. If this is done incorrectly, the project data will not be consistent and will be compromised. When changing field choices for radio buttons, checkboxes, or dropdowns, the best practice is to leave the current choices as is and continue labeling with the next available code. The coded choices do not have to be in order, so you can insert or list choices as needed. For example, the current symptoms are coded as 1 for fever, 2 for vomiting, 3 for rash, and 4 for other. If you need to update the choices to include diarrhea, do not update the codes to 1 for fever, 2 for vomiting, 3 for rash, 4 for diarrhea, and 5 for other. If the data is improperly recoded so that 4 for other changes to 4 for diarrhea after data has already been collected, any records previously selected to indicate 4 as other will now look as if the response is diarrhea. While it's possible that the case may have chosen other and written in diarrhea, it's not guaranteed diarrhea was the other symptom. The best practice is to update the order of the choices to 1 for fever, 2 for vomiting, 3 for rash, 5 for diarrhea, and 4 for other is listed last. If alphabetical order is desired, then the choices should simply be reordered but not recoded, so that the order is 5 for diarrhea, 1 for fever, 4 for other, 3 for rash, and 2 for vomiting. To ensure you represent data consistently with the correct code throughout the project, it's critical to think through how the variables in the project will be coded. Make sure choices are labeled correctly before moving the project into production and gathering real data. If the coding is changed while in production status, REDCap will automatically send an email to the REDCap administrator when the changes are submitted, asking the administrator to review and approve the project before the changes can take effect. All higher risk changes such as this are sent to the administrator for review. Now that we've discussed the importance of placing a project into production status and the associated consequences of failing to do so, we'll demonstrate how to move the project to production status. Click on the Project Setup tab at the top of the screen. The project status shows the project is currently in development status. It's important to note that surveys must be enabled while in development status. If a user forgets this step, the REDCap administrator will either have to enable surveys for the project or move the project back into development status so the user can make the change. Under the main project settings at the top of the page, click Enable for Use Surveys in this project. Review each section on the project setup page. You should progress through the steps in order from top to bottom. The final section has a button with the words Move Project to Production. Click this button. It's possible that a REDCap setting may be enabled where a REDCap user cannot move a project into production status, but instead, the project must be moved into production status by someone with administrator privileges. This setting provides a safeguard as the administrator must confirm the project is correctly set up and ready to collect real data using surveys. Any records that are in the project at this point should be records that have been created to test the features and flow of the project. These are called test records. When a user requests a project be moved to production status, REDCap will automatically ask the user if they would like to keep any records already created in the project or if they would like to delete the records. If real data is entered in development status and a user mistakenly chooses the option to delete the records while pushing the project to production status, the system will delete all data. This data cannot be recovered, even with the administrator's help. Therefore, data retention is not guaranteed for projects in development status. However, data collected while in production status will remain secure. Once the project is moved to production status, a large green checkmark will appear by the production section on the Project Setup tab. It will show the word Complete. Though there are other survey sections to complete on this page, a survey can now be sent out successfully. On the left-hand side of the screen, under Data Collection, click on the Survey Distribution Tools link. This link appears after surveys have been enabled within the project. A notice will appear stating the Survey Distribution Tools page cannot be viewed until one or more surveys for your data collection instruments have been enabled. While project-level survey settings have already been set to allow surveys within the project, each instrument that is to be a survey needs to be enabled as well. This is so the REDCap user can choose which instruments are sent out as surveys and which instruments are kept as data entry forms, limiting outside access. Close the pop-up and click the Enable button under Enabled as Survey for the instrument. This brings the user to a new tab called Setup My Survey. The top of the page now shows the survey status is active. Change the option to Survey Offline when you no longer want respondents to be able to access the survey or when the survey needs to be paused for modifications. The remainder of the Setup My Survey page has many options to customize surveys. Customization options can be found in an instrument's survey settings. Basic options include creating a survey title and providing instructions displayed at the top of the survey page. Additional design options include adding a logo to the survey header, changing the background, font, and heading colors, and adjusting the size of checkboxes and radio buttons. Survey options also include sending confirmation emails at survey completion, allowing users to return and modify previously answered survey responses, and capping the number of survey responses submitted. Surveys can also be set to expire either at a specific date or a set number of days after surveys are initially received. Additional customizable survey options are available in the survey settings. Once you customize your survey as needed, scroll to the bottom of the page and click Save Changes. Once an instrument is enabled as a survey, you can access the Survey Distribution Tools link. Click this link. Consider the method that should be used to distribute the survey. The first tab displays a public survey link, which is a generic link. Anyone with access to the link will be able to complete the survey. Each completed survey will create a new record within the project. If an epidemiologist is physically filling out the surveys for a case, a public survey link may be appropriate, as they will be the ones with the link. Public surveys are the fastest way to send out a survey and collect responses. A public survey link can also be customized. REDCap supports letters, numbers, periods, dashes, and underscores in a custom URL. For example, a custom survey link can be renamed with a shorter URL, such as Outbreak Survey. If your survey is targeted toward a specific audience, such as a foodborne case interview, a public survey link may not be appropriate. Another way to distribute a survey is to use the participant list, which is indicated by a tab at the top of the page. The participant list is defaulted as anonymous. Responses will be anonymous unless the survey contains questions that gather identifying data or the participant identifier option is enabled. REDCap allows the option to mass email all participants with a unique link to their records. It then tracks when the invitation was sent. If the survey is set to send on a time delay, it will notate what time the survey is set to send. REDCap includes an option to email all participants based on different criteria. The email can include a unique link that will direct participants to their specific records. This is a good tool for sending out reminder messages to respondents who have only partially completed their survey and asking them to complete their questionnaire. The participant list can also track survey completion, as a column shows if participants have responded. Tracking survey completion will be discussed further in the next video. This concludes the video on creating and disseminating REDCap surveys. The next video in this series will focus on adding users to REDCap projects, entering data, and tracking survey completion.